Hi guys, how are you? I hope all you are doing good. Welcome to the Learn Code Easily. So today we will do jump game, and this is our million level question, and we will solve this question today. So in this it is given that we have maximum jump length at each value represents the maximum length of jump at a particular position. We have to return if we could reach to the end without any problem. What is meaning of if we could reach to the end? So if I will give an example. So let me delete this. So what I'm saying, just see that if I have 3, 2, 1, 0, 4, this is the steps which we have to follow. So the first step we could reach to 3. These are the three step. As you can see, if we directly jump 3 step, so we reach a point from where we cannot reach to any of the point. Could not reach to any of the point. Because why? Because the step is 0. So where we have to take a step, that is 0. Means we do not have right to take any of the step. So we will stuck at this point. So let's follow another one. So if we take two step, only two step, so here I can take one step. So if we take one step, then also we have reached 0. Means we cannot reach further. Okay, so here just assume that I have taken one step only. Now we can take two step. So I have taken two step, that also I will reach to 0. If we take only one step, then I will come here, I can also take one step. So again I am reaching at 0. Means there is a problem. We cannot reach to the end. We have to reach at the end here. So that's the meaning of problem. Why we could not reach? Now let's take that example. Two, three, one, four. Means let's take first scenario. If we take two step, then I can take one step. I can also take one step. Now you can see I have reached at last. Okay, so follow another scenario as well. I have taken only one step. Now we can take three step. You can take one step, then you can take one step, then you can take one step. So we have reached last as well. We have reached at last point. That is correct. Now we can take. Now I have taken two step here. From three, I have taken two step. Now I can take one step. I have taken. So again, I have reached at last. Now from here, I have taken only one step. Now I can take one step. Again I can take one step. Now I have again reached at last. You can see in all three scenarios we can reach to last. Let's take the all scenario I have completed. I can take two step, I can take one step. So these two you can see I have taken two step then one step. From here I can take one step, from here I can take two step, from here I can take three step. All the scenario I have covered. As you can see there are three ticks and there are means there are three steps, there are three different scenarios I have taken. So with all approaches I can reach to last. I hope you have understood. Now the point is how we will do it. So what we will do, I will see that from here where I could reach, the maximum point I could reach at this point. So this is the point I could reach, and that is not zero. So it is certain that we may or may not reach to end. Means it is certain. What is certain? Certain is we may or may not. If it is zero, then it is certain that we could not reach. But it is not zero. Means the possibility is there. The possibility is there that we could reach to the end. So at this point I have seen that I could reach at this point. Now again I will come to 3 and I will check that from 3 the maximum step which I can take is 3 and I can reach at which index. I can reach here, I can go here, I can go here. So I can reach to the end. So for everyone I have to check that whether I could reach a point that is non-zero. I could reach here. If I am here, I could reach here. Means there is no zero point, and you can see that I will contain a max that will take care the maximum step which I can take, or you can say a max that take care that whether I have reached to the end or not. So this is array of I. So what is meaning of this one? Why I have to maintain that one at every point. So at this point if my I is 0, so 0 plus 2 is 2. I can reach at second index. You can see here this is 0 index, this is 1 index, this is 2 index. I have reached at second index. Okay, so max value is 2. I will again take if my I is 1, so max is 2. So I is 1 plus 3, 4. Means I have find a maximum value. So I have to initialize with the maximum one, that is 4. Okay, I have reached, means I will reach at index 4, and this is my last index. I will again check. Now if I is 2, then max is 4, that is less than or equal to 1 plus 2, 3. No, 4 is less than 1 plus 3. If my I is 3, that is 4, that is also correct. So I will again come and I will again initialize with 4. So and I have to reach here, so I do not run a loop from I 0 to I less to the endpoint. I can run our loop from here to here. Because ultimately I have to reach at the end. Means from here I could reach, from here I could reach, from here I could reach, from here I could reach. So there is no point of taking this. I have to maintain every time 3, 2, 1, 0, 5. I have to maintain every time a max variable. Max take care that whether you will reach to the end or not. So here if I is 0, so 0 plus 3 is 3. And if I is 1, so initially I will initialize our I will initialize our max with 3, and my loop will run from I to 1, and I will check that max 1 less than or equals to I array of i. Array of I is taking care that at which point I could reach, the maximum point I could reach. So the max is 3 less than or equals to I. I is 1 plus 2, that is also 3, means 3 is less than 3, that is correct. So I will come here and I will initialize our max with 3. And I will check that a point which I am I will check that whether the current value is 0 or not. If it is 0, complete this one, then you could know that if it is 0, then what will happen. So if I is 2, now you can see 3 less than 2 plus index is 2, value is 1, 3 is less than 3, okay, so max is again 3. As you can see that every time I am reaching here and that is 0, so I will 3 less than 0 and no 4 0 1 2 3 sorry that is 3 plus value 0. Now 3 is less than 3, yes it is correct, but I have to check my array of I should not be 0. Why? Because if it is 0 and every time I am reaching, every time I am maintaining a max, and max is maintaining the maximum value which we could reach, which we could take and we could reach end. So every time if I am maintaining a max variable and that contain the maximum value, and even if we are maintaining a max variable that is maintaining a maximum value, means if we are maintaining a max, we are maintaining a max, and even maintaining of max value we have reached a value that is 0. That means if we have reached a point that is 0, so we have to check at every point that whether my current of array of I is 0 or not. If it is 0, we can say that we could not reach. This scenario should not come, for that we are maintaining our max variable. We are taking care that whether we could reach to our end or not. If instead of maintaining, even we are maintaining the max variable and we have reached a point that is 0, means it is very simple that we could not move further because we are maintaining every time a maximum variable, a maximum value, and we have reached a point that is 0, so we could not reach further. So I hope you understood, guys. I will implement the same solution. So let's begin. So what I have told you, I will maintain a max variable. So first I will check that my length of nums, if it is 0, so what I have to return, if it is 0, okay, so nums of length should be always 1. If it is 1, so we have to return true, otherwise I have to maintain a max variable, that is nums of 0. And I will run a loop that is returning from, I have told you already that there is no mean of taking the last one as well. So if my max 1 is less than or equal to I plus array of I, that is nums of I, so if it is nums of I, and we have to check that if our nums of I is 0, so we can simply say that we cannot reach to our end. Otherwise, if it is not the case, then just initialize this one with this value and okay, so otherwise you have to return true. So what I have done, let's see. So if it is not greater than, so we have to, okay, so it is, so let's submit it and see that whether it is working or not. So there is something wrong is it is 0 and we have maintained 0 as well, so this is 0. So what we can say, if nums of 0 is already 0, means we cannot reach if it is of length 1. Okay, so this is wrong. The nums of length should always be 1. So before initializing our max 1 with any value, I have to check that value should not be 0. If it is 0, means we cannot take any of the step from the beginning. Zero comma 1, then 1 comma 2 comma 3, then 1 comma 2 comma 0 comma 3 comma 8 comma anything we can say 2 comma 3 comma 4 5. Okay, so it has run perfectly. Let's submit it. Okay, if it is 0, so what we can say, we can simply say that if the length is 1, so no matter, because we have already at our end. So if length is 1, so we have to simply return true. If it is not, then I have to check that whether nums of 0 is 0 or not. If it is 0, we have to just return false. That's it. Because if it is 1, whether it is 0 or not, it doesn't matter. Even if it is not of length, that is 1. If it is not, then I have to check that the value which I am going to initialize, that is 0 or not. If it is not, then just initialize it and just complete my solution. If it is 0, that means we cannot move further, we cannot take any of the step from beginning. So that is guide. It is 80% faster. So I hope you have understood, guys. I will meet in the next video.